In this video, we're looking at a vertical free fall problem where two rocks are dropped 1 second apart from the top of a 55 meter high building. Those are going to fall under the influence of gravity and hit the ground. And we're asked three different questions here. In part A, we want the time it takes for the first rock to hit the ground. So we write down the equation for the y coordinate as a function of time in vertical free fall. And that's really the same as our first kinematics equation for constant acceleration, y equals y naught plus v naught y t plus 1/2 at squared. It's just that we already subbed in that the acceleration is negative g. Now, supposing the origin is at the ground level, our final y coordinate is going to be 0 for the free fall. And we release this rock from rest, which means v naught y is 0, so that term is gone as well. We put in the initial height of the rock, which was 55 meters, and we'll go ahead and put in our approximation of g, and we're using 9.8 for that. This leaves t as the only unknown in the equation. So we just subtract the 55 from both sides, multiply by 2, and divide by 9.8, then square root the result. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 3.35 seconds. In part B, we're asked to compute the height of the second rock when the first rock hits the ground. So remember, the second rock was released 1 second later. Well, it's been falling for 1 second less than 3.35 seconds. And that means the fall time so far for this rock is 2.35 seconds. Now again, we just write down the y coordinate as a function of time for vertical free fall. And again, we're releasing this thing from rest, so the term with v naught y in it is 0. And this time what we're looking for is the final value of y for a given value of t. So I'm going to start with my initial height of 55, and then I have a minus 1/2 times g, which is 9.8, times the fall time for this rock, 2.35 seconds, all squared. Into three significant digits, we get a final height of 27.9 meters. Finally, in part C, we want to get the speed of each of these rocks when it hits the ground. And of course, that speed is going to be the same for either one of them because they're both released from rest from exactly the same initial height. And I think the easiest way to do this is to write down the kinematics formula for the velocity as a function of time. Remember, that basic kinematics formula is V equals V naught plus AT, but we're going to sub in A equals negative G. Then remember, our initial velocity here is 0 because we're releasing the rock from rest. And now we just put in G. And we put in the fall time to hit the ground. That's the whole 3.35 seconds. Into three significant digits, we get 32.8 meters per second. And notice that there's a minus sign on that because we were using this velocity equation with a coordinate system in which downward is negative. Now, because we were asked for the speed of the rock instead of the velocity, we'll just get rid of that direction, the minus sign, and just write the answer as 32.8 meters per second. Now, it's also fine to use what I normally call the third kinematics equation. That's the one that's time independent. That's v squared equals v naught squared plus 2a times the displacement, which in this case I'll call y minus y naught. So of course, we just replace a with negative g. And again, v naught is 0, so that term is gone, and y final is 0. And I end up with v squared is equal to positive 2g. When we multiply the negative 2g times the negative y naught, the result is positive. So we have 2 times 9.8 times y naught, which was 55. So all we have to do is smash those numbers together on the right-hand side and take the square root. And when we run the numbers on this, we get the same 32.8 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.